Here we have another application problem where we need to use a Venn diagram. We've got the fact that a survey of 73 customers was taken at a bookstore regarding the types of books they purchased. Survey found 42 purchased mysteries, so we'll represent one of our circles with an M to represent that set. 33 purchased science fiction, and then 27 purchased romance novels. 17 purchased mysteries and science fiction, 14 purchased mysteries and romance novels, 8 purchased science fiction and romance, and 4 purchased all three types of books. So as we begin to complete the Venn diagram, we want to begin in the region that's the intersection of all three of these sets. So when we go through and look at back at the application problem, we see that 4 purchased all three types of books. So this region, which in Roman numerals, that was represented with a 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So I always go to that intersection of all three sets first. And then we're going to look at these regions, the ones that are intersections of two sets. So these three regions. So the next thing that we'll look at is, and we can pick either one of those three regions. Let's look back in our problem. I see that 8 purchased science fiction and romance novels. So the intersection between science fiction and romance novels, which would be this area, needs to have a total of 8 purchased. We've already accounted for 4, so we need 4 more, so that now that entire intersection would equal 8. And then let's go to 14 purchased mysteries and romance novels, so that would be this section of the Venn diagram. 14 total, so this section that we've outlined in red needs to contain 14 total. We've already accounted for 4. So this piece would be have 10 remaining. And then we do the same thing with the 17 purchased mysteries and science fiction, which would be this area of the Venn diagram. 17 total, so in that green section, 17 total, 4 have already been accounted for, so we would have remaining 13. And then we're going to go to these outer sections. So go back into your problem. It says the survey found 42 customers purchased mysteries. So the entire, what I'm circling with yellow, that needs to have a total of 42. So I would take the sum of these three, which is 27. And then 42 minus 27 gives me 15 for this section, for this region. I'll do the same thing with 33 purchased science fiction. I'll do that in purple. So this purple circle needs to contain a total of 33. Right now we've got 13, 4, and 4, which would be 21 total. So 33 minus 21 leaves me with 12. And then we'll do the same thing for the romance novels. I'll go back to red here. 27 purchased romance novels. Right now I have a total in this circle of 18, so 27 minus 18, which would leave me with 9 for that region. And then lastly, before I go in and answer some of these questions, we did have the information that there were 73 total customers that were surveyed. Now I need the sum of all the regions, and so all the people that have been accounted for so far. So if I take 15, 13, 12, 10, 4, 4, and 9, I get a total of 67. And then 73 minus 67 would be 6. So there are 6 people who took the survey that did not fall into one of those categories. So now let's use the Venn diagram to answer these questions. How many customers surveyed purchased only romance novels? So only romance novels would be in this region that contains 9. The 10, the 4, and 4 had other books that they purchased as well. So just 9. How many purchased mysteries and look very careful at these words and or. Okay, how many purchased mysteries and science fiction but not romance? So we want with and, that's the intersection. We want the intersection of mysteries and science fiction, which would be here, but not romance novels. So we can't take into account the 4 that also read bought romance novels. So that would be only 13 as the answer. How many purchased mysteries or science fiction? Now, or is the same thing as the union of those two sets, and corresponds with the intersection, and or corresponds with union. So, how many purchased mysteries or science fiction would be the union of these two sets? So all of these people that are contained in those sets, we need to take the sum of those. So the sum of 15 plus 13 plus 12 plus 10 plus 4 plus 4, which would give you 58. Part D, how many purchased mysteries or science fiction, but not romance novels? So the same two sets that we looked at, however, we're not going to count these 3 that are also contained in the romance novel set. So we're looking at only the 15, 13, and 12, which would add up to be 40. Part E, how many purchased exactly 2 types of books? So we know that that center region were people that purchased all 3 types of books. This part would be the intersection of mysteries and romance novels, but not the science fiction. So this part, this region, and this region would be the parts that only had 2 types of books. So 10 plus 13 plus 4 is going to give me 27.